To create a business manager account, open a new tab and visit business.facebook.com. I'm going to leave all of these links down in the description below. Show notifications. I don't want notifications. Here, I'm going to continue on Meta Business Suite and all of that. Click on done. Click on this drop down icon with your Facebook page name and then click on create a business account. Then give your business account a name. I'm going to use blogging school. Then you want to enter your personal details here. And for the name and the surname, make sure the names you enter here correspond with the name you have on your valid ID. Same with your Facebook account. You want to make sure you're using the same name on your Facebook account as it is on your ID. This is because at some point, Facebook is going to ask you to submit your ID for verification. So make sure the name is matching. Yeah, I'm just going to enter the name I'm going to use for this process. And then for business email address, paste the email address right here and then click on create. Here, what do you want to claim into this business account? Claim your Facebook pages and all of that. I've only created a Facebook page, so I'll check the Facebook page. If you've created an Instagram page, you can check your Instagram page, WhatsApp account as well. But the only thing I have right now is a Facebook page, so I'm going to click on next. Then you can add other people to your business. I don't have any other person to add right now. So if you have other people working with you on your business, maybe an employee or something, or you're hiring a marketer, you can add them here. But I'm not going to do all of that. I'll click on next and then click on confirm. And with this, I've successfully created my Facebook business account. So if I click here, you see that we have a business account here and then a Facebook page attached to this business account, right? So this is how it is. You can create up to 2 different business accounts with your Facebook account. So what you want to do, even if you want to have 2 business accounts, just create one for now and start running ads with this. There's no need to jump and create 2 of those accounts immediately. Maybe with time, you can create another business account as backup or for a different purpose, whichever one you choose. But now we have our business account ready, which means we have the 3rd item checked. Now, the final thing we'll need is a Facebook ad account. And to set up our Facebook ad account, let's come over here again. And then you want to click on all tools, then click on ads manager. And it's going to bring you over to this blank page. And this is because we've not created any ad account before. So there's no way we can see an ad account here. But what I just want you to do is to click on this menu icon and then come over to business settings. There are a lot of stuff you can do here. And with time, when you start running ads and you get to need them, you learn how to do them along the line. But let me just focus on the things you are going to need right now. You come over to accounts. For accounts, we have a Facebook page already. So what we need now is an ad account. You can come over here to link your Instagram profile with your ad account. And then you can come over to WhatsApp account and add your WhatsApp account. So you can do all of that if you need to. But our concern right now is ad account. So come over to ad account. And then you want to click on add. And then you want to click on create a new ad account. And that's because we don't have any ad account right now. Then you want to give your ad account a name. I'm going to use blogging school. Then the time zone, you want to select your local time zone. This is very important so that you don't get confused with timing and you don't get the wrong currency attached to your ad account. So I'm going to look for Lagos, which is GMT plus 1. So here's it, GMT plus 1, Africa, Lagos. Then for currency, you want to select Naira. This is very important because if you select USD, for instance, you know that you can't make dollar payments with your Naira card. And if you select a USD account, that means you need probably a domiciliary account or any virtual dollar card. And the implication of that is you have to be paying higher because you'll be buying dollar at the market rate. So for peace of mind and to make everything easy for you, make sure you select Naira as your account currency. That way you can pay for your ads with your Naira card, regardless of the bank you got it from. It just has to be a Visa or a MasterCard. I'm going to click on next. Who will this ad account be used for? Select my business, except if you created it for another business, then I'm going to click on create. Then to be able to use this ad account to create ad, you want to give your Facebook account access to this ad account. This is your Facebook account, check it, and then turn on full control to this ad account, and then click on assign. And with this, you successfully created your ad account. The next option is to add payment info. There are 2 ways to add payment info for your ad. You can either add it to your business account or you can add it to your ad account. You have a business account, and with your business account, you can have multiple ad accounts. So if you want to have different payment methods for the different ad accounts you are going to have inside your business account, then you can just add their payment method separately. But if you want to use the same payment method for all the ad accounts you have inside this business account, then you can come over to payment methods and then set up a payment method that you can use for all of them. So let me set up a payment method for this ad account. I'll just add payment info. As you can see here, our country is correct, Nigeria. For me, currency, Naira, time zone, Lagos, GMT plus one. If any of this info is not correct, you want to change it, because after now, you will not be able to edit your currency and all of that. So I'm going to click on next. Then you can see you have two payment options here. Either pay with debit or credit card, or use Naira payment with MasterCard through PayU. This is the option you want to go for: Naira payment with MasterCard or Visa using PayU. So select this option and click on next. This is how your Naira, Visa, or MasterCard is going to work. For VAT ID, I'm going to skip this. That's completely optional. Then you want to add some amount of money to your ad account. For the sake of this video, I'm going to add just 2000 Naira because I'm not going to use it eventually. And then I'll click on next, then continue to pay you. Here, you need to enter your card number, card name, expiry date. After entering all of these details, I'll click on pay. So authenticating your transaction. Then you need to verify using a one-time password. I'll just use text and then click on continue, and then I'll enter the verification code. I have the code here, so I'll just type in and then click on pay. I've successfully added 2000 Naira to my ad account. So if I click on open in ad manager here, I'll just go ahead and accept this, then close this. Does your business focus on politics, all of that? No. And then here, I can just click on all tools and then click on billing. You are going to see the amount that we have here. And we are using a prepaid balance. So this way, you are going to fund your ad account before using it to run ads. If you want to fund your ad account, you can just click on add funds, then enter the amount you want to add. Still use PayU again and follow the same process to add money to your ad account. And that's that. Let me come back to business settings. Let me show you something here. Now, if you want to add a payment method to your business account, here under business settings, just come over to payment methods. Right now, it is showing no payment method, so you can click on add payment method. So you can just do that by assign finance editor to yourself, then click on next. Then here again, you need to select your currency. I'm going to change this to Naira. Right, so you see Nigerian Naira here. You have only debit or credit card. Click on next and then add the card you would want to use. Okay, it's that simple. But I'm not going to do that right now, so I'll just close. Then another thing you can do again is to come over to business info. You can add all of these details to your business: your legal business name, business address, the business phone number, the website, if you have tax ID. Here you have this business verification status. This is not really necessary. You can just move on without this. Another thing is this two-factor authentication. It's very important that you protect your Facebook account with 2FA. So if you don't have two-factor authentication on your normal Facebook account yet, go and download the Google Authenticator app or any 2FA app you want to use and set up 2FA for your Facebook account. And if you don't do that, Facebook might restrict you from running ads. So it's very important that you secure your account with 2FA. I've not used 2FA for this account yet, but I'm going to do that in a moment. Then if you scroll down here, you'll see my info. And it's showing email address not yet verified. So let's just verify our email address. I'll click resend verification email and then go ahead and check my email inbox. So here's the confirmation email. I'll just open it and then click on confirm now. This is not actually working. Maybe I'll check back later. But basically, you have the basic things you need to start running ads. And you can just click on all tools, then click on ads manager. And this is where you can start setting up ads from. But before I start creating ads, let me show you how to set up 2FA for your Facebook account. To set up 2FA, come over to your Play Store or your App Store and just search for Google Authenticator. There are a lot of other authenticator apps out there, but Google Authenticator is the most popular. And then just install this app to your phone. After installing, click on open, click on get started. Now you have the Google Authenticator app. The next thing you want to do is to come over to Facebook, then go to your Facebook account, then click on your account icon, and then click on settings and privacy, click on settings. Under settings, come over to security and login. Then you want to look for two-factor authentication. So I have two-factor authentication here. Click on edit. Then you have different 2FA options. you can start to use authentication app, which is the method we are going to use, and it is a recommended method. Then you can start to use SMS, where is your phone number and all of that. I'm going to use authentication app. Then you want to enter your Facebook account password and then click on submit. Then you can either copy this code. As you can see here, inside the authenticator app, we have two options, scan with a QR code or enter a setup key. So if you want to use scan a QR code, you can scan this code here. Or if you want to enter the setup key, just copy this key and paste. So I'm going to use scan a QR code. So I'll select scan. And then once you are done with that, you can see that you've been able to generate a code right here. And this code changes like every now and then. So even if somebody sees this code right now, it's impossible for them to use it to hack your account later. The basic thing is Facebook wants only authorized people to have access to advertising on the platform. And that's why account security for advertising businesses is very important. So I'm going to click on continue and then just enter the code that I currently have, which is 162253. And with that, I've successfully set up two-factor authentication. Now that we have 2FA security on our account, your Facebook ad asset, that's your Facebook business account, your Facebook ad accounts, your Facebook pages will not be restricted easily, right? So if you follow all the things I've been talking about all through, it's going to be very hard for your advertising access to be restricted. The only thing you need to know is when you start running ads, maybe after your first ad or a couple of ads, Facebook is going to restrict your account and ask you to submit a valid ID. In that case, you don't have any problem. Just take a picture of your ID, a very clean, clear picture, and then upload, and your access will be restored, okay? Just in case Facebook restricts your advertising access, requiring you to verify your ID, you can just click on All Tools and then come over to Account Quality, and you'll see the button where you can submit your ID and your advertising access will be restored. It's that simple. And that's it, guys. I hope you found this video helpful. Before you go, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons. And if you want to see something else, click here to see the video that YouTube is recommending you watch right now. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.